Okay, I'm gonna make a quick video. Why isn't the scale moving? Okay, I'm gonna get into this topic real quick. The scale is bullshit. I'm just gonna say it straight up. Do not rely on the scale. The scale is just another form of data that you can collect with body weight. That is mass. So mass means anything. Mass that has weight. So, for example, if I weigh myself with my clothes on, do I have that, and I weigh naked 160, and if I weigh myself with clothes, I weigh 163, do I have 3 pounds of fat? Do I have 3 pounds of water, or I have 3 pounds of clothing on? See, that's why it's called mass, and that's why it's called body weight. That's the only thing the scale can detect. And if you have those fancy little scales that has the fat percentages on that, that's also bullshit, okay? It cannot scientifically mass, it can't dictate fat unless you took your fat and literally put it on a scale, but that takes you dying to do so. But this scale, it only detects mass. So that's body water, that's your skeletons, that's water retention, that's sodium intake, how much carbs you eat. You have to take the weight on the scale that determines how much you weigh, which ain't terrible, but people think that's, if they go on that vacation and gain 4 pounds, that's 4 pounds of fat. All just 4 pounds. No, that's literally 4 pounds. Probably 2 pounds worth of shit you probably forgot to weigh yourself. Probably 2 pounds of that is water. So you guys have to keep in mind, the scale is bullshit. That's a little warning. The scale is bullshit. That's why I suggest using measuring tapes, photos, progress photos is a good one. Calculating, so track your meals to know that you're in a calorie deficit consistently. That's what I'm doing with my mini cut. That's really the best street, tracking calories if you can, measuring tapes and photographs of yourself every week. If you guys have anything to suggest, suggest down below in the comment section, but that's what I can think of. But the scale is the least form you should really be looking at to subjectively see where you're at. You really should be using the under 3 metrics that I suggest. But why isn't the scale moving? That's today's question. Well, we had to go on many factors. How long was this diet? Because your body hormonally will change over time. Your metabolism will change over time. If you weigh lesser than you was before, if you take a 170-pound individual and they're doing 4 weeks in their diet and they weigh, let's say, 165, they burn different amount of calories now. They are a lighter weight, you know? And if a lighter weight is doing the same activity level, but burning less calories because they have less mass, less weight, they will burn less calories, therefore lower the deficit. So if they was on a 500 calorie deficit at 170, but now they're at 165, they're probably at a negative 300 calorie deficit. So that's another form of your body changing their calories. Also NEAT, non-exercise thermogenesis. During that time, your body will accumulate, try not to expend more energy because they want to survive. They want to hold as much fat. It's not called survivor mode. They just want to hold as much fat on their frame in case of plague or anything else, you know, in case of famine or anything of that sort. So they want to store as much fat. So they might lower your daily activity level, like you talking or you going on that walk or you biking. You might incline not to do so. Or you might not be moving around like this, you know, that's neat, or bouncing your leg. So that's another factor you have to keep in mind. Another factor why the scale ain't moving is in a calorie deficit for a long time, probably 8 weeks right now, you probably did adjust your calories, but the body probably adapted quick to that, and you're also probably not as active as before when you was full of energy, calories. So you might have to lower your calories slightly or increase activity. And two people would do this. Me, I would increase my activity because it's so simple. Or if you're working as an office job or sedentary, you probably would decrease your calories. But we have to think of psychology, mentally, because I'm not effing eating 2,500 calories on a cut, even on a mini cut. That's like crazy to me now. Before I could, because I used to eat less, I used to be less active, so my body regulate to that. But right now, I'm not doing that mentally and physically. I'll probably go on the bench the next day. So you have to think of how much are you willing to lower your calories just to be on this deficit. That's another reason why the scale ain't moving. Because you didn't lower your calories or increase your activity level or keep up with your activity level. Make sure it's in check. Also, the scale could have a plateau. That's also a factor, is maybe you have to reverse diet it, get back your metabolism, because the metabolism will slow down due to body weight, hormones changing because you're being lighter. Muscle, you might lose some muscle. You're not going to lose a lot if you hit protein and weight. Lift weights, you're not gonna lose a lot. Of course, if you don't lift weights or eat the amount of protein that you need, then yes, you will lose muscle and then you'll be a fat, smaller version of yourself. But if you lift weights, eat protein, you'll lose the least amount of muscle, but you will lose a little bit, so that would dictate how much calories you do burn. And obviously, the body doesn't want muscle on a cut because it takes too much calories, you know? And you're already starving yourself with 500. So it's going to try to, you know, take away of that. So you might be hit a plateau, a plateau might happen. Well, it's a different sense of plateau might happen. If the scale ain't moving every single week, then I would say that's a plateau. But the scale shouldn't be moving every single day. If it's moving every single day, like 1 pound, 1 pound, 1 pound, 1 pound, 1 pound, next week, 1 pound, 1 pound, like the third week is still moving, 1 pound, 1 pound, 1 pound, unless you're not like 350 and above or like a higher body fat percentage, the scale moving shouldn't move that fast in a given day. Of course, it depends how much you weigh. It depends how much body fat you have. So if you're like a 400-pound individual, you can lose 2 to 3 pounds a week. That's perfectly fine. Maybe 4 pounds even. But if you're like a leaner individual, 25 to 20%, maybe 2 pounds at the max is good for you. And obviously, if you're leaner than that, 17-15%, 1 to 1.5 is probably good. But you shouldn't be losing weight every single day. And of course, I want to get to this. The first day, the scale will move fast. It will move fast because it's water retention. That's mostly water. It's not fat. So the first couple of days, it will be like 4 days, it will be mostly water. Because you learn your food intake, food volume, water intake of the carbs, storing of the water. Every like one carb is like 3 grams of water. So you learn that. And also food volume, like I said. But the second week, then you want to measure. And obviously, you want to see a weekly average, not every day. Because every day, it's just noise. You don't want, it doesn't matter. You want to see a weekly average. So if you're losing 0.5 pounds and that's not fast for you, you might want to lower the calories, increase activity a little bit higher. Of course, you want to adjust your calories probably because that's difficult. If you're really trying to lose weight every week and let's say, for example, the scale ain't moving, but you know you're in a calorie deficit, you know you're active, you know you're moving, your body's actually responding faster, that's why the scale is not accurate because you can easily burn calories. No, you're in a calorie deficit, but your waist is shrinking, but the scale ain't moving. So you might be doing something wrong, but you're really not. It's just the scale is just a total weight. Your body would try to also hold water too. So you could weigh 165 for 2 weeks, but actually been losing fat. And that maybe if you're a higher fat individual, you're probably gaining muscle on top of that. So you got to keep in mind, you might actually gain muscle depending on how much body fat you do have, of course. But if you're a leaner individual and trying to lose weight, yeah, of course your body's not going to try to lose that weight, that water, or that fat. That's why I suggest trying to get a measuring tape or progress pictures to accurately see if you're getting leaner each week or each month, too. But each week is more plausible. But that's really it, guys. The scale ain't moving because due to many factors, like I said, the metabolism, hormones, changes, water retention, the body's trying, you know, keep as much fat, etc. But you guys, I really highly suggest use a measuring tape and progress pictures. The scale is really just an evil god that we subconsciously or consciously look up to, thinking that's everything. If we gain 4 pounds on the dang scale, doesn't mean anything, or 10 even, depending how much sodium, carbs, or how much food volume you have. Because I could take a 2 pound shit and that's really 4 pounds. I thought I gained a muscle fat, and that's like 2 pounds of shit. So scale is bullshit. Scale should be the last metric, but really focus on that measuring tape and focus on that progress pictures and try to make sure your activity is on par with that deficit. If you have your maintenance calories or track your calories too, I highly suggest just to get a ballpark where you're at. But that's my little tip for today. Keep on track, keep grinding, guys. And if you need a nutrition coach that can help you on this journey of tracking calories and making sure you're on your goal, just go in my description below. You can check me out and we can discuss with a free consultation, 30 to 45 minutes, and discuss how we can achieve your goals. Thanks, guys. Bye.